We've learned in our journey with Ferodo thus far how much wear and tear your brake discs can take. We've also learned how vital it is when repairing your brake pads that you check out your discs for any foreign materials and, if needs be, get them skimmed. And it seems that technology in this area has come on leaps and bounds. That is, what are we dealing with today?
I brought you to H&M Auto Tuning today to show you exactly how a disc is skimmed. Now, I've showed the viewers at home exactly how a disc looks after skimming, but that's still skimmed on the old way, where you've actually taken the disc off the vehicle, took it to a machining shop, and they've skimmed it and returned it to the workshop and fit it to the vehicle. But that's very time consuming. Today, I'm going to show the viewers exactly how onboard skimming is working, and today, our technician Neil is here to assist us in this, what he does day in and day out.
No offense, Neil, but this looks like a very small setup here. What's going on in this tiny little box?
Now, this little machine has got a little electric motor in the box itself that's connected with shafts onto the hub area of the wheel to be able to turn that disc to simulate the same that you'll get in a normal machining shop. And we've got a tooling head that will actually machine both surfaces at the same time, because remember, these two surfaces must be parallel to each other to ensure that there's no shutter on the vehicle after skimming has been done.
Now, just to show you how much I've learned from our past experiences, we've got to know that we've got enough actual disc to be working with in this case.
Yeah, that's very important. Neil will actually check the thickness of the disc before he starts skimming. Otherwise, you might skim the disc and it's a waste of time altogether, because the disc is too thin to be able to operate safely on a vehicle itself.
I was going to say, you can see the lip is quite pronounced there, but that's not the only thing we're checking for.
Yeah, we're not only just removing the wear lip on the end of the day. We want a nice clean contact surface for the pad to bed in properly within the first 100 kilometers. And the second thing is to remove all foreign particles or debris or old friction material that's been embedded in the disc itself.
All right, where do we begin?
First thing, Neil is going to remove the wear lip on the disc itself. So we'll be able to measure the disc, ensure that there's enough material to remove for the disc to still be within thickness specification. Neil, let's get started.
A disc has a typical wear life of around 2 to 4 millimeters, so make sure that it is checked properly and replaced when worn. Disc skimming renews the friction surface. Regular maintenance by an expert is not expensive and can save you money in the long run.
Neil, all right, good job.
Now, Neil has skimmed the disc, we've seen how it's done, we've measured and ensured that everything is within specification, it's safe to use it this way. Neil has fitted the new set of Ferodo pads onto the vehicle, so hopefully we're going to have many happy miles on this vehicle again.
And of course, vehicle-specific brake pads.
Always remember, stick to the right part number for the right application.
Right, any final tip for the day?
While the wheels are off, we always check little small things around the braking system, like the hydraulic hoses and the shock absorbers on, and the overall condition of the vehicle and the suspension itself. If anything is out of place, rather take it into a specialist, get it fixed, ensuring that that vehicle is safe for use on South African roads.
Well, you've got the little checklist to follow. You've been educated, no excuses. Remember, prevention is always going to be better than the cure, especially when lives are at stake. You can join the family. Ferodo Brakes is where you can find us on Twitter, or join the community on Facebook, Ferodo South Africa.
You're in control with Ferodo.